नमस्ते एवरीवन, साहिल दिस साइड, वेलकम यू ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल रिसा योगा एंड दिस इज द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ माय आर्म बैलेंस वीडियो। सो इफ यू हैवंट वॉच द फर्स्ट पार्ट, आई विल रिकमेंड यू टू फर्स्ट गो एंड वॉच दैट पार्ट बिकॉज यू शुड नो विच आर द मूवमेंट्स आर रियली इंपॉर्टेंट टू लर्न आर्म बैलेंस, हाउ टू इंक्रीज द ब्लड फ्लो इन द आर्म एंड हाउ टू टोन द आर्म। नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, इन दिस वीडियो वी आई एम गोना शो यू सम प्रैक्टिसेस व्हिच इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट टू इंक्रीज द आर्म स्ट्रेंथ। Because some of my students, especially women, they always say, Sahil, we don't have enough arm strength to do arm balance. So after this video, I will say, no excuse, please. Practice every day, these all practices, and soon you will see if you have sagging problem in your arm, it will gone. If you don't have enough tone in your arm muscles, you will get the tone definitely. And it will really, really important to increase the arm strength. So let's start the video. So first is, we always start with the push-ups. Remember, I already did my all first stretching and the movement of the arm. So if you haven't watched the first video, go and watch. I'm reminding you again. Now, first video is push-up. Now for the females, let's start with that. So for the females, first you need to take cat position. In the cat position, remember, stretch and place your palm down. After this, you need to take your knee slightly back. All right? Now keep your toes in, shift your body weight slightly forward, look up, arm lock, remember the first video, and shift your body weight forward and go down. Now if you are beginner, what you can do, you can place the block here. Remember, the block should come under the L shape. Now you need to place the block here, and after this you can lock your arm. Remember what I am doing here, I am not taking my tailbone backside towards my back, okay? It's in. So you need to maintain this, go forward, go down and up, go down and up. Now what are the common mistakes here, the people they do, especially the females. Now what happened when we are practicing any kind of plank, we are practicing push-up or knee push-up, everyone try to bring the belly forward, and after that this happens, they cannot come back. Okay, so what you need to do here, remember, once you will engage your core, can you see I'm bringing my tailbone towards the pubis like samasthiti here, by maintaining your samasthiti go forward and then come back. So remember, note this, can you see my back, this is wrong. So here you need to keep your tailbone in and go forward and go forward. This is how you can practice. No need to go completely down, just go half until here and come back. So practice this. You can start with 5, you can start with 10, but remember, you need to practice this minimum 5 rounds. If you are practicing starting with 5, let's say start with 5 rounds, no problem, 5 5 5 5, 25 only for the day. Then next day try to add little bit and reach minimum for 10. So in one set 10, practice 5, minimum 50. So if you are practicing knee push-ups, so here you need to practice minimum 50 push-ups every day to increase the arm strength and to give the tone to your arm muscle. Now in this, the next, I will also show you the same practices with the wall, but later. Let's finish first here. Now first exercise we have done. Now for the sandwiching exercise, you need to again remember, stretch, open your fingers, lock, go into down facing dog pose. Now here remember, you need to stretch completely, all right? Keep your arm muscles engaged nicely, and now drop your elbows and up. Now if you are not able to do it with the both arm, you can do also one by one. So 1 2 1 2, 1 2 1 2. Now important part, when you are practicing with this, if you are not able to straighten your arm, no problem, but the thing is, do not allow your elbow to go out. So one, until the time you will try to lock your arm, your elbow will be in, okay? See, because it's engagedness, I'm applying the external rotation, so it will be, the elbow should be towards the leg. If I lose this, this will happen, okay? So every time you need to maintain the engagedness of your arm, keep shifting your body weight back, and then it will come like this. Now, for the females, yes, if you are not able to do in the down facing dog pose, easy, you can again. So remember, cat position, knee back or arm slightly forward, lock, fingers open, go down, up. Start with this, no problem, okay? But if you are able to do the down facing dog pose by placing your heels down or up, if you are not able to touch your heel, still you can practice this. Here, down and up, down and up. So practice this as much time as you can. Again, better to practice anything in a sets. So either you can practice 5 times or 10 times. Again, stretch it until 50, not continuously, but you can divide 10, 10, 10, 10, 5 rounds. So 5 round push-ups, 5 rounds, arm bending in down facing dog pose. Now the third practice I'm gonna show you, it was little bit challenging, not too much, but yeah. So how to practice? For this you need to take the plank position. Now remember, not this, in. Now from the plank position you need to bend your arm. Start with the right arm. So right arm down, left arm down. Now right arm first. Now check, it's straight in the line of the elbow, and then left. So when you will come up, it will come straight. So always remember this. So first, 5 times with right, and then 5 times with left. Let's start. Right. 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 Okay, and then with left. So I'm showing you only 3 times, so you can practice very easily. Remember where to place the palm. And do not lose your belly until the last. Now, so I showed you the 3 practices. First is knee support push-ups. Second, arm bending in down facing dog pose. And the third, bending of the arm from plank, come in lower plank position. So you need to practice this. And now let me show you the other practices, that if you are not able to do it here, how you can practice. And one more practice I want to show you, that is for your triceps, because females especially, they have the problem for the sagging problem. They want to look good, they want to feel this line triceps. So how to achieve that? Observe. For the females, again you can place the knees down. Try, when you will go down, it should come near to you, so you need to make it like this. After this, you need to look up, arm lock, okay, and tailbone in, not out. Go forward, see, it's coming front of the chest. Chest is forward. It can be difficult for you, but try it if you have strong arms. And for males, no need to drop the knees. So try to go completely down. So this is how the males can practice easily. Now, as I said, I will show you the same practice with the ball now. Two practices so I'm gonna show you. First is ball arm push-up, and then the same, the last one, triceps push-ups. Okay, so let's start. So now I'm gonna show you the push-up with the wall. Now, if you don't have the mat and still you want to practice, so no problem, you can use any floor, you can practice anywhere. But yes, if you feel that lower push-up, the floor push-up is not useful to you, or you cannot do it, no problem, you can practice with the wall as well. So I'm gonna use this wall. So how to practice this? Remember when you are with how to place the palm. First thing, you need to keep the elbows close to your ribs first, keep it in. Now observe is, you need to make this L shape. So when you will practice the push-up, it should be here. So let's start with this. I'm going with this. I placed my arm here. Now when I will go forward, it will make the L shape. So it should be not here. It should be not too much down, otherwise the pressure will come on your wrist. It should be at straight. It should be horizontal. It's vertical. Now how to practice? You need to take your leg slightly back. Again, remember, keep your tailbone in, do not keep your tailbone out. Once you keep your tailbone in, you just need to go straight. how easy it is. Anyone can practice, even my students, doesn't matter what's the age, even the 64 years lady, she practiced 200. You will not believe, but 200 push-ups she practiced with the wall easily. So you can, once you start with the wall, try with 50. You will feel it's super easy. You will not feel any pressure. So you can practice minimum 100. So every day you need to practice minimum 100 with the wall. Here, how to place the palm, observe, vertical, horizontal. Place, keep your legs slightly back, do not completely stand close to the wall. Slightly back, tailbone in, and just go. Simple as that. It's very easy, anyone can practice. Now, the last practice I have showed you, it was for the triceps. Again, the same practice you can practice here as well. Now remember, it should come front of the chest. Again, leg back. I'm holding like this. You can place your flat palm completely on the wall. Okay, so go. And you will feel the burning here on the triceps very easily. So these are the practice to tone your arm muscles, to increase your arm strength, and it will help you to get ready for the arm balance practices. So in the next video, I'm gonna show you the core role. So it will be really important video for everyone, because we don't know how to shift the body weight, how to use the core. Because for the arm balance is really important, the core role, the glutes role, muscles role is really, really important. So in the next video, I'm gonna show you shifting of the body weight and how to use and activate your core, how to feel the core during the arm balance class. And after that, in the fourth and the last, I'm start to show you one by one all the poses. I have already made the video on Ashtavakrasana, Ekpakonasana, and Bakasana, means the crow pose. So if you haven't watched that video, you can go, you can, if you have the enough strength, go directly, watch that all three videos, different people are really liking it, especially the Ashtavakrasana. I'm getting really good views, really good comments. Review it, go it, read the comments. And if you think I should watch it, I am ready, please start watching all the videos and start practicing. And I'm gonna show you how to practice the arm balance. I will show you the different techniques of the arm balance, not just one. So if you have the chair, how you can practice. If you don't have anything, how you can practice with the wall. So all these things without jumping. Okay, I will not show you with the jump. I will show you very precisely, step by step, all the easy method I will show you, and all secrets that nobody is teaching you, how to do the handstand and with all these techniques. So I will show you all that one by one. So keep watching this series, arm balance series, specially made for you. So until that time, stay tuned with us.